Y'all doing all right? You okay? I'm screaming at you. I'm just asking a question. Y'all giving me a clap. I'm like, a yes is fine. Okay. Thank you. Praise God. I tell you, I know everybody's in the same mess. I'm telling you. We all are. I know that, you know, and I'm just, you know, I'll be the first to tell you, you know. I'm a mess, but God is dealing with me every day. Every day I'm trying to learn, you know, how I can be less of a mess. You know, he showed me, look, Lauren, you know, you're the problem, okay? I'm going to show you how you're causing the problem, and now I want you to be the solution. And that's what all of these songs are about, this problem, cause, and solution. Free your mind, you know. It's like we all think that the gospel is join a church building, and that's deception, you know? The real gospel is repent, which means let go of all that crap that's killing you. Life was supposed to be a pleasurable experience, not this this torment, you know? And when I realized that I was tormenting myself for, it was about my lust. It wasn't things that I needed. It was just, you know, all these security blankets. I mean, the more I acquired, I became more of a prisoner. I mean, you know, 40 people on staff and you can't do nothing, and now creativity is impossible because all you can think about is all these folks that, you know, you're supporting and carrying, and, you know, it's not good. You know, a friend of mine says that every tub has to stand on his own bottom, you know. And in that respect, we all get to do what our passion is. See, that's what praising God is all about. It's doing your passion. You know, it's not useless, worthless ritual. You know, monotonous ritual where we just show up and can't wait to see the game. You know, it's doing your passion, fulfilling your passion. You know, that's how we're thankful. That's how we say we appreciate the opportunity to be alive. You know, and I'm glad that I don't have to slave anymore. You know, because music was my love, and because of everything I thought that had to accompany my music, it became my burden. It just got stolen from me. I said, what is this? How did this thing that I love so much, so easily and so quickly turn into something I loathe and hate? And so now, you know, I understand it was because I was measuring myself or trying to compare myself to a standard that wasn't reality. It wasn't the standard at all. You know, there's a scripture in the Bible that says we compare ourselves amongst ourselves, you know. That's not the standard. You already are the standard. What are you trying to fit into a standard for? We were each created to be individual standards, you know? And we're trying to fit into a standard. It doesn't make any sense, you know? So now I'm just, you know, after all that, I'm just ready to be me. And it's a lot to work through, you know, because all of us have hidden in these little boxes purposely because of parts of ourselves that we were unhappy about and we didn't love, just because we didn't understand, you know, because there's all this social doctrine that says, you know, that the infinite God with all this expression who created every single one of us absolutely different on purpose wants everybody to fit into the same suit. I'm like, you know, that's deception. That's deception. Okay, let me just, I think this is the wrong one. I don't think this is the right one. We were in Florida this weekend, and we took the kids to Disney World, and we were going, you know, they gave us a tour, so they escorted us through the back. And when they escorted us through the back, we got to see how there was all these people working all hard, and it was like real dirty back there. And of course, in the front, it was all immaculately clean. And I said, you know, people need to see the reality. They need to see, you know, how these people slaved to maintain this illusion. It felt like my life. I said, if people only knew what it was, it's like, you know, a bunch of musicians, listen, busting their, all right, working all hard to make it look easy. What's the point? Yeah, I'm a, you know, oh, I just threw this together. You know, it's like, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, slaving to act like, you know, I wake up like this. And none of us do, you know, none of us do. None of us do. And reality is good, because that means everybody can just exhale, let your belly out, you know, and chill, you know. But people get mad at me when I say, look, let's stop fronting. And I'm saying, you know, that's the blessing. Now we can go around and look at each other and say, oh, you got one too? And be free. We want to defend the curse, I tell you. That's not fun. Did it for a long time. Too long. You didn't find it? It's another white one. But it's either in my purse or the other bag or the green one. Ghetto. You know, it's reality. Are they ready? Oh, let's see. One time, it came to me, you know, I was just told very concretely, you know, it was like that voice, the right one, said to me, he said, Lauren, you know, the real you is more interesting than the fake somebody else. I just want you to know that. Because we always thought we can get, you know, we could get reality by just putting on the clothes and wearing the face and, you know, looking hard in the video or, you know. Reality, it's like I would always talk to my husband, I said, look, you know, we look at Bob Marley, we say, okay, let's just grow locks and wear the clothes and have the band. And we have no idea how many years of struggle and pain and suffering that made that content. You see what I'm saying? You can't get it from the outside in. Truth is from the inside out, you know? And the way we've been trying to heal and be healed is with these topical, surface, superficial, temporary solutions. And I'm telling you, true healing is from the inside out. You know, we've been told to protect our outer man while our inner man is dying. Oh, this is the one. Okay. Boy, I tell you, God made him for me, I tell you. I'm something to put up with. And to endure that is amazing. I'll be the first to tell you, trust me. Y'all can clap, because that's some real work. I was in the room, you know, before we came out here. And he said to me, I said, Ro, should I change? And he said, yeah. So I looked at him, I said, why you tell me to change? I was comfortable, man. But I asked him the question. So I went in the room, and I tried on all these clothes. And I was like, I feel like an idiot. So I pulled out all these clothes, and I'm saying, okay, bro, you know, pack the bag neatly. You know, could you put the clothes back in? And he's like, all right. So he's trying to do this, but then I'm like, no, now take this out. Now put that back and take that out. Put that back, hold that, take that, put the orange shoe. So I'm like, and after a while, I just said, bro, baby, could you leave? Please, get out the room. And I just put back on the clothes I came in, okay? I was like, I'm just not there anymore. I'm not, I'm telling you, it's like... Oh. And you know, he's learned, because before we used to just beef, and now he's like, okay. I'll see you later. I'm out. Yeah. Oh man. It's real, but God gave us a brand new relationship, man. I mean, one in truth, you know? It's like we date people, like let's say we you know, we're interested in somebody, and we put on the perfume and dress up, and then we do things that we'll never, ever, ever do again. You understand what I'm saying? It's like, and that's why so many marriages end up in divorce, because people wake up next to a stranger, they say, who the hell are you? What are you doing in this bed? Where's that man that used to do duh-duh and duh? And I'm saying, just give them reality from the door, because see, love, you're gonna attract love, you know, and the one that really loves you. And then you don't have to pretend and falsify and, you know, and keep that posture, you know. You know, I can't, I'm just like, I never forget when I first met him, I said to him, it was like, you know, he saw me eating in front of him. And he was like, you eat like a man. You must not like me. You know, because women are usually, you know, that posture. And I said, nah. I said, it's not even that, you know, but this is reality. This is, you know. And that's it, man. I mean, I'm telling you, it's so wonderful to finally find, and trust me, it's a work. It's not something that happens overnight. We all have to be introduced to each other. I'm telling you, I know that I'm up here, and you know Lauryn Hill, and you came to see Lauryn Hill, but this is the first time y'all meeting me. You see what I'm saying? Don't think you met me before. Okay, and as I grow, you're gonna meet me a little bit more. You're gonna be exposed to the real me a little bit more. I had to reintroduce myself to everybody I know, my mother and my father. Amen. Listen, y'all never knew me. I wanna introduce you to me. I'm just getting to know me. And you know what? Anything that's not growing is dead. So we better be changing. You know, people will say to me, they will hold me hostage. And they seriously, emotionally hostage. They say, she's changing, the money's changing. I said, listen, the money's not changing me, God is changing me. I'm changing because that's a natural part of life. We're all supposed to change. Who wakes up and is the same way tomorrow and the day after that? Nobody is. Let the experience teach you and be real, man. And there's gonna be warfare involved because there's some people who prefer deception, see? They say, I don't like this new expression. And I say, well, what, you want two-thirds of me to stay outside? I'm a whole person. You can't say, you know, two-thirds of Lauryn come in here. Only two-thirds is acceptable. I'm a whole person, you know. And that's everybody. We always talk about spiritual warfare. We didn't realize it was within relationships. It's emotional warfare. Being able to tell the people we love the most the truth about ourselves. And when they say, hey, that doesn't fit into our box for you, and we say, well, I ain't in no box. Don't try to put me in one. I'm gonna play a little bit of guitar with this one, but I might stop a little bit because I want you to hear the words. So if I stop, you understand why. I want you to really hear the words.